drunk.
What in the blue blazes is this?
That would be an alligator taking a dip in the pool at this Alabama home. The guy who lives here says that he thinks the gator actually climbed over his fence, dropped into his backyard, and then dove into the pool. The guy behind the camera obviously was a little spooked by what he saw, but listen to his reaction. It was priceless.
Get out of my pool, man. I am flabbergasted. You own an alligator and you missing one. He in my backyard in my pool. Come get him. Thank you.
So the gator eventually got out of the pool and then hung around in the man's backyard until a wildlife officer came by to pick it up. The guy who lives there says that he will definitely be double checking now before he dives into his pool.
I'll take your gator in a pool and raise you a gator blocking an elevator.
Okay.
This encounter happened at an Estero apartment complex.
Yeah, Lee County deputies got a 911 call that people were trapped in the elevator thanks to the little guy you just saw.
Well, tonight NBC2's Victoria Reslow is discovering that's not the only memorable gator tale we're seeing this week. Check it out.
Oh, that hurt.
It's a tale to remember.
We have no idea even where it came from.
One Laley High School athletic director, Bill Matola, saw firsthand.
Personally, I was trying to remember exactly how fast did they tell me alligators could run, because I didn't want to get too close to that thing.
This gator strolled through Laley High this morning, right near kids practicing.
Our football team is working out on the football field. Like I said, our cross-country team is running on the roads. Really didn't want him to get over that fence.
Videos of this big gator were posted to Twitter, some saying maybe the cold-blooded critter wanted to come back to campus early, but this gator isn't the only one showing up to places uninvited.
I mean, this is a brand new complex. It was, you know, freaked me out a little bit.
FWC says this fella, a mere 3 feet 8 inches, blocked people from getting off the elevator at Estero Park Apartments in July.
I'd turn around the other way, go back up the elevator, and stay up there till it's gone.
Even though gator mating season runs April until June, Ray the Trapper says we could be seeing more because water levels have dropped. So they'll go anywhere they have to find it.
7'6½".
Ray caught the larger gator at Laley High School today and brought it to a farm in LaBelle. And another trapper with FWC secured the small one.
I mean, it's a little baby gator, so it's nothing too scary, but means there could be a lot more out there.
FWC says if you ever see a gator, keep your distance or call the nuisance alligator hotline.
Hopefully we don't have another 7½-foot alligator around for a long time.
Victoria Reslow, NBC2.